Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Redeeming God, we give you thanks and praise for the opportunity and privilege to be here today. To celebrate with joy that you're coming into this world. You're coming, O God, to deliver your people from the bondage of oppression, from the bondage of sin and death, so that we may go to live with you into eternal paradise. Even as we celebrate today, we also look forward with joy to celebrate the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. And so as we worship, may we seek to put our souls in order, so that on that great and glorious day, we will with joy go with you into paradise. Through the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The hymn for the procession, 384.
Thank you. last Sunday, we lit the second candle in our Advent tree and celebrated the patriarchs. This first chapter reminded us of our hope in Jesus Christ. The second candle reminded us that love is the fulfillment of the law, and through Christ we experience the love of God. Today, we light the third candle of the Advent tree, the candle of joy. When the angel Gabriel told Mary that a special child would be born to her, she was filled with joy. She sang a song that began with the words, "My soul glorifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Savior." Just as the birth of Jesus gave great joy to his mother, so his presence in the world gave joy to those who had none before. He healed them and gave them hope and love, and they believed in him.
Jesus taught his disciples to rejoice at his second coming, as the meeting will bring eternal joy, for we will be with him forever. John 16, verse 22. 1 Peter 4, verse 17. Joy is a fruit of the indwelling presence of the Holy Spirit that grows from within us. And this joy is rooted in a personal relationship with the God of love. Also, the joy we experience in worship and prayer gives us courage to proclaim the good news of Jesus and the gospel of the kingdom of God. We light the candle of joy to remind us that when Jesus is born in us, we have joy, and that through him there will be everlasting joy on earth. Joy is like a light shining in a dark place.
And as we look at the light of this candle, we celebrate the joy we find in Jesus Christ.
Let us pray.
Thank you, God, for the joy you give us. We ask that in way for all your promises to come true, and for Christ to come again, that he would remain present. Help us today and every day of worshiping you, to hear your word, and to do your will by sharing your glory with your Father. We ask it in the name of the Lord.
A reading from the Word of God, written in Isaiah chapter 61, reading verses 1 through 4 and 8 through 11. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to provide for those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of a faint spirit. They will be called oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, display his glory. They shall build up the ancient ruins. They shall raise up the former devastations. They shall repair the ruined cities, the devastations of many generations. For I, the Lord, not justice. I hate robbery and wrongdoing. I will faithfully give them their recompense, and I will make an everlasting covenant with them. Their descendants shall be known among the nations, and their offspring among the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge that they are a people whom the Lord has blessed. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My whole being shall exalt in my God. For he has clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness, as a bridegroom decks himself with a garland, and as a bride adorns herself with her jewels. For as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as a garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all the nations. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 40 for today, Psalm 136. When the Lord restored the fortunes of thine, then we were like those who dream.
Then we have a walk through the laughter, and our tongue will shout of joy.
Then they said among the nations, the Lord
has done great things for them.
The Lord has done great things for us.
And we are glad indeed.
Restore our fortunes, O Lord.
Like the water courses of the Nile.
Those who sound with tears,
weeping with sounds of joy.
Those who go out weeping, carry the sea.
Will come again with joy, shouldering their sins.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Word of God, written in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, reading verses 16 to 24. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the spirit, do not despise the words of the prophets, but test everything. Hold fast to what is good. Abstain from every form of evil. May the God of peace himself sanctify you entirely. And may your spirit and soul and body be kept sound and blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you.
Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to God,
our Savior. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. This is the testimony given by John, whom the Jews sent priests and Levites from Jerusalem to ask him, "Who are you?" He confessed and did not deny it, but confessed that "I am not the Messiah." And they asked him, "What then? Are you Elijah?" He said, "I am not." "Are you the prophet?" He answered, "No." Then they said to him, "Who are you? Let us have an answer for those who sent us. What do you say about yourself?" He said, "I am the voice of one crying out in the wilderness, 'Make straight the way of the Lord,' as the prophet Isaiah said." Now they had been sent from the Pharisees. They asked him, "Why then are you baptizing if you are neither the Messiah nor Elijah nor the prophet?" John answered them, "I baptize you with water. Among you stands one whom you do not know, the one who is coming after me. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandal." This took place in Bethany, across the Jordan, where John was baptized. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise Christ, O Lord.
Which goes, "Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks for the Holy One. Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ, his Son." And now, let the weak say, "I am strong." Let the poor say, "I am rich," because of what the Lord has done for us. Give thanks. Then I don't know if you could just play the chorus.
Thank you.
such a powerful curse. However, if we do not practice living a life of gratitude, the words of the chorus would somehow be meaningless to us. The chorus reminds us to always be grateful and to never forget to give thanks to God. This is for two main reasons. First, because God gave us His Son. And second, because of all the things God has done and continues to do for us. Paul the Apostle may have been in a similar frame of mind to the writers of to the writer of this chorus when he was speaking to the brethren in 1 Thessalonians 5:19-24. Here, although issuing a set of instructions, Paul reminded them that it was God's will that they should rejoice always, pray continually, and give thanks in all circumstances. Paul told them, though, that in doing all this, they should not quench the spirit or despise the prophecies. He reassured them it was good to challenge things. However, they should hold on to what was good and shun what was or even had an appearance of evil. Paul told them, when this was done, they would be sanctified by the God of peace, and hopefully their whole spirit, body, and soul will remain blameless until the return of our Lord Jesus Christ. This is a powerful reminder for us today, and so profound at this time of the year. Christmas is coming. In another 2 weeks, we will be celebrating Christmas. Although things may not be as active this year due to the virus as they have been in last year or in former years, there will still be the festivities, and persons will still be celebrating. There is no other season or time of year where there's such a buzz of activities, where many persons are shopping, traveling, cooking, partying, and going to church. Paul in 1 Thessalonians 5:16 is reminding us that there's nothing wrong with this. Rejoice evermore. Rejoice always. But it is a season when we are reminded of the birth of Christ and the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, rejoice, be happy. After all, why wouldn't we want to celebrate the birth of Christ? It is because of His birth we will gain salvation. Birthdays were meant to be celebrated. Everyone should rejoice when they gain another year to life and not take it for granted. Don't just sit home and turn it into a sad occasion. Celebrate, rejoice, because you are among the living and still have the opportunity to continue God's will. The three wise men showed us the importance when they came from afar to celebrate Jesus' birth, and they left rejoicing. We too, as Christians, should show our joy and rejoice and celebrate Jesus' birth. In verse 17 of the same scripture, Paul posited that even while rejoicing, we should remember to pray continually. Brothers and sisters, the devil does not like happiness. No, he doesn't. Especially if the joy that we're experiencing comes from the Lord. He hates it. John 10:10 tells us, the thief cometh not but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. Satan is going to come at us when we're happy and rob us of that happiness. We cannot fight Satan on our own. We therefore need to reach out to God. We have to pray and continue praying. Never stop. Pray that we fall not into temptation, because this season is not called a silly season in vain. During this season, many persons get carried away. There may be temptations to steal, to get drunk, to do wrong, to drive recklessly, to be promiscuous, to neglect church, to not throw our tithes and offerings because the money is needed for Christmas shopping, and the list goes on. There are so many temptations. Praying will allow us to hold steadfast to God and His words. Praying will keep us away from temptation and will keep the temptations away from us. Praying will give us life and save us from sin. Praying will also remind us to be thankful. When we pray, we have to always remember to give thanks in spite of the circumstances. Old-time people often use the cliche, things could have been worse. It is true. We could have been in worse situations than we are, but we are not. So we need to be thankful. Quit complaining. Quit trying to keep up with the Joneses, because the Joneses are broke. They have no financial or spiritual wealth and help. They just choose not to tell us or to publicize their affairs. We need to be grateful for what we have and for what we will receive. God wants us to be grateful, even when we face adversaries. It is through the adversaries we face that we will come to know God. The challenges we face in life forces us to lean on God, to trust Him, to call out to Him, to have faith, to pray, and to give thanks. When we are down, ill, or suffering, God will give us peace, comfort, and strength. If we ask Him, and even if we don't, He will, because He knows our hearts. If we have no money and we ask Him, God will provide enough to sustain us. Therefore, in good times and bad times, we should always give God thanks. Some of us, though, can be very ungrateful, and through this attitude, we will vex the Holy Spirit. However, Paul is reminding us in verse 19 and 20 not to quench the Spirit or despise the prophecies. We cannot take God for granted. Sometimes when we have reached the pinnacle, or we have climbed a ladder to success, we tend to forget to say thanks or to put God into the picture. We become so preoccupied, so consumed with work, with growing the business, with taking care of the family, with gaining wealth, that our spiritual life and the time we should spend on things related to worshiping God fades or become irrelevant. Many times, God grants us our wishes, our happiness, health, and strength, and we do not give Him the time He deserves. We do not say, thank you. We do not say, thank you, God. At Christmas, many of us tend to focus on grandma's day or night and the other festivities, yet we cannot spare the time to come to church, to even thank God for allowing us to see another Christmas, or even to be able to make our purchases for Christmas. We have to remember, God is a jealous God. And he warned us through Deuteronomy 6, verse 12. Then beware, lest thou forget the Lord, which brought thee forth out of the land of Egypt from the house of bondage. The same metaphoric staircase that God allowed us to climb to the top or even the middle, it is the same staircase he will use to take us back down and humble us. Many of us are familiar with the former Minister of Education situation. God deserves all our attention, all our praises, all our gratitude. In worshiping him, we need to share with others the goodness he has done in our lives and in the lives of others we know. We should not be afraid to live for God and allow the Holy Spirit to shine its light through us. As Paul pointed out to the brethren, we have to feast on the words of God to know right from wrong, to know good from evil, and to strike a balance so that we can be purified or purged from our sins. He further emphasized in verse 23 that the onus is on us to live pleasing lives, one that is wholesome in spirit, body, and soul, so that we will be prepared when there is a second coming of our Lord. Brothers and sisters, our work on earth is to fulfill the will of God. It is not his will for us to be miserable and sad, but he wants us to be happy, to talk to him through prayer, and to remember to always give thanks. Amen.
Amen.
Spirit. He was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For
intercessory our prayers. Holy Lord, you come to us. You inspire us. You enable us. Grant that we may proclaim your loving presence and show your saving power. Let your church be seen to be working for justice and righteousness, for liberty and peace. Lord, that we may live at peace and oppress no one. Make us instruments of peace within our communities and within our home. We pray especially for leaders, for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, Howard, the Diocesan Bishop and Archbishop of the West Indies, Leon, Suffragan Bishop, Winston, Ronaldo, and Orlando, and to all others who hold office in your church. Lord of freedom,
yes.
Remember for you all who are seeking freedom. We pray for nations burdened with great debt, for families who have lost their homes, people denied justice. We pray for all who are suffering from violence or tyranny. We pray for the work of Amnesty International. Remember all who care for prisoners. We pray for any who are hostages at this time. We pray for Patrick, the Governor General, Andrew, the Prime Minister, Mark, Leader of the Opposition, and all the members of Parliament, the Senate, councillors, and group leaders. Lord of freedom,
yes.
Lord, teach us to appreciate what we have and to be aware of all that is done for us. Let us not take each other for granted. Let us hold fast to all that is good and abstain from every form of evil. May our homes be homes of holiness and hospitality, of grace and goodness. Lord of freedom,
yes.
Remember in your holy presence, God of liberty, all whose lives have been diminished by poverty or neglect, all whose confidence has been lost through harsh treatment or scorn. We pray for those who have been betrayed, especially those betrayed by loved ones. Remember all who have suffered through robbery or slander. We pray for all who have lost their dignity through illness. Remember friends and loved ones in their troubles. We pray that all who are bereaved at this time, especially the family of Mervyn Ellis, may be strengthened. We pray for our sick and shut-ins, especially those of this cure and especially of this church. We also remember all persons who are suffering from COVID-19. We pray that you will touch and heal them. Lord of heaven, Lord of freedom,
yes.
Lord, you have done great things for us already, and yet greater things are to come. We pray for all who have departed from us. May they be numbered with your saints and know the glorious liberty of the children of God. Lord of freedom,
yes.
During this moment of silence, let us pray for needs and for those of others, whether known or unknown. Let us say together, come, Holy Spirit of God, come on us, that you may send us out in your power. Fill us with your grace and goodness, that we may be able to bring the good news to the oppressed, to comfort the brokenhearted, and to bring liberty and freedom to your people. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Father forever and ever. Amen.
If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, God is faithful and just and will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us therefore confess our sins.
Almighty God, Almighty God, we have sinned against you and one another, in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have done. We are sorry for everything of all our sins, for your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, for he was all that is God.
Grant that we may serve you in this life, for the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness. And keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The kingdom of God is justice, peace, and joy. Inspired by the Holy Spirit.
The universe of Christ has accepted of God and approved by others.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you.
His grace is always coming. We thank you all for ourselves, our lives, and over. We come to your Holy Spirit, a reasonable, holy, and a high sacrifice. As is bread and wine from the body and blood of Christ, so we meet all your people with the confidence of your love, through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give up thanks and praise.
It is right and a joyful thing. Always and everywhere to give thanks, Father Almighty, everlasting God. Because you sent your beloved Son to redeem us from sin and death, and to make us heirs in him of eternal life. That when he shall come again in power and great triumph to judge the world, we may without shame or fear rejoice to behold his appearing. Therefore we pray, join your voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. He gave it to them and said, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it,
heart and forget the mystery of our faith.
Thank you.
of God, for the people of God.
Our souls will be satisfied, and we will sing that song of praise to you.
Thank you.
Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, speak to us. Almighty Father,
we thank you for meeting us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. May we who share his body, may drink his risen eye. We who drink his cup, unite with others. We upon whom there is spirit that shines, unite to the world. Help us to continue in faithful witness to your word. So we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name. Through Christ our Lord.
For your heads, for God's blessing. The Son of Righteousness shine upon you. Guide your hearts and scatter the darkness from before you. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you all.
Amen.
Serve the Lord.
In the name of Jesus.